So I decided to come out here to the beach today for this video so that I could talk a little bit about asking people to take their photo, which I know is a little bit ironic considering no one's here. It's a very windy day. I'm new to Victoria here. I just moved here a couple months ago and I don't know that many people. And in the past, a lot of my photography has really revolved around taking pictures of people. They were sort of the dynamic forces. And while I think it's really important, and I have been actually pushing myself to take pictures of other things, of abstract shapes, of light, buildings, plants, I still find people the most exciting. I know when I first started with photography, especially because I liked candid photos, I always wanted to capture the raw moment. And don't get me wrong, I think that there's so much value in that. I really enjoy truly candid photography. But I think that there's also something really great to be said about engaging with people. If you are confident and if you are skilled, you can often get a very candid moment. So I'll give you an example. When I was living in New York City, I was working for a photo agency there. And every weekend, I would take my camera, I'd put a 50 millimeter lens on it, and I would just wander around a different neighborhood, and I would just stop people and ask them if I could take their portraits. And I'm gonna put some of them up here now. I really love this series. Each interaction was only about like a minute long, maybe even less. I would ask the people if I could take their photo, and then I would snap it, and then I'd get their name. And one of the things that was really powerful about that experience was seeing how really willing people were to share that sort of moment with them. And I think the two things that really allowed me to do that were, first, a level of confidence in myself and in my camera, and second was actually the execution of that confidence, of those skills. So let me explain. The first thing is, anytime you're taking pictures, like a lot of times the camera can be quite large and feel a little bit cumbersome. And if you are feeling intimidated by that camera, the people who are your subject, they are going to feel intimidated too. It's very much like doing interviews. I read somewhere that it's like you're the host of the party. You know, if you're having a great time, it gives everyone else permission to have a great time. They're going to follow your lead. And it's the same thing with photos. If you are confident and comfortable holding that camera, even though it can be big, then it starts to melt away if you're just treating it like it's part of your arm. So when you engage with someone, you say, hey, can I take your photo, or could you stand here for a quick second so I can just snap a photo? When you come with that sort of positive energy, people really respond well to that. And then the second part of it, which is very important as well, is the being able to execute really quickly. And that's where you do have to have the skills, but you don't want to be messing around with your settings. You want to just be able to execute quickly. So usually if you have an idea of, or if you've already taken a couple photos to sort of set up the scene, and then all you need is a person in it, then you can get someone in and you can take a picture quickly. And why that helps is that, you know, you've used all this confidence to convince them to come in, but then you're gone in a second. And what I find is that a lot of times, if you're seeing something, you can be like, hey, can I take your photo? People will say yes. If you're really quick in there and then out again, it's almost like you weren't there. I mean, it is different than just truly candid, but you know, a lot of times you still get a very authentic moment, and that can be really powerful. So maybe what I can do now is I can show you a couple photos that I've taken over the last little bit here in Victoria, where I asked people if I could take their picture. This is a photo that I actually took just last night, and I was headed downtown to maybe do some street photography in the night, but the sky was just so beautiful, and I knew there was this rock outcropping I had to get to, so I raced there as fast as I could. And when I got there, it was beautiful. The sky had turned purple, and there was this one guy just sitting out on this rock outcropping. And I took a couple of snaps of him just sitting there. He was kind of like laid into the rock, and I took a couple of pictures of him totally candidly, and they were nice. But with the moon and the sky and everything the way it was, I knew that there was a better composition. And when I just took some straight photos of the landscape, those were nice too, but they didn't sing to me. And so I just reached out to him. I said, hey man, would you mind just standing here for a second? I'll get a quick photo of you. And he was totally game for it. And I snapped off a couple quick photos. We exchanged phone numbers, and it turned out amazingly. Now, the second photo I'll show you was actually taken not at this beach, but at a very similar beach. And I had been walking along, and there was this sort of fence structure that had a lot of symmetry to it, and the scene was really beautiful. But again, it just felt like it was just lacking something. I needed something. And this couple, young couple, had just come up over the hill behind me, and I turned around and I grabbed them and I said, "Hey, do either of you want to be a model just for a minute?" And I had a vision for what I wanted. I wanted someone standing on the fence. And so when the guy said, "Yeah, sure," I said, "Okay, great, just, you know, come over here, 1 foot here and 1 foot there," and sort of maybe looking up to the side or looking over here. It was another moment where I was just able to grab someone and pull it together. Now the last one I'm going to show you here is actually just a straight portrait. I'd just been going out and I've been taking some photos, and the photos I was taking of buildings I wasn't really enjoying. I wasn't liking them. I didn't think that they were really compelling. But it was a really beautiful night, and there was a number of people out on the beach, and I just started asking people, "Hey, can I take your photo? Can I just take a quick picture of you sitting here? You don't have to do anything. I just want the photo." And there's this couple who had like a pizza box, and they were sort of building a little structure to get out of the wind because it was windy that night too. And I stopped and I shot the photo of them. And it's interesting because a lot of times I like photos that are a little bit more candid, that people aren't looking at the lens. But in this photo, they're both looking at me, and it was such a quick moment that I captured, that I got with them, that it just felt super genuine. You know, they were just really enjoying, you know, at the end of the day, having a little bit of food and enjoying each other's company down on the beach and sort of playing around with each other. And especially the woman on the right, I feel like her expression just rang really true to me and felt like sort of a natural moment. And so maybe to recap, I'd say that candid moments are wonderful and excellent, and I totally encourage people to search for those and to capture them. But it can be really powerful to ask people, even strangers, if you can just take their photo. And the two keys to that are confidence and positive energy when you're going in, that you're just wanting to share with them sort of the things you're doing out there, right? And then the quick execution, because not only does that get you a really genuine moment often, but that also means you don't overstay your welcome. Kind of like right now, I don't want to overstay my welcome. So that's it for today, and I'll have to find my way back home, but maybe after I enjoy this beach for a little while.